That's one. And the Malam Nisf Shaban, Nisf Shaban, the night of Nisf Shaban. There are two things here we have to cover. What is in Shaban? Part of what is in Shaban, something very important for the Ummah, which they practice everywhere in the Muslim world, which is Nisf Shaban. Dua, Salah, Tahajjud, they read three times. Yaseen, Baraka, long life, good health, protection from Bala and Musiba. Practicing good deeds, protection from sins, and happiness for dunya and akhirah, depend on the three the intentions, inshallah, all good be in Allah. For the month of Sha'ban is a very blessed month. And let us first go through few things which has happened in the month of Sha'ban. Of course, there are many hadith about the month of Sha'ban and narrations about it. But there is also al-akhbar wal-athar. What is al-akhbar wal-athar? The news of that reached to us about the previous nations before Islam, other prophets and messengers and their life. So in the narrations, one of them, for example, he said in the month of Sha'ban, it was the birth of Sayyidina Yahya bin Zakariya alayhi salam. Nabi Yahya bin Sayyidina Nabi Zakariya alayhi salam. Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered his prayer and he blessed him with a pious son. Not son, pious son. He was Salihin. So that's one of the things. Ijabat al-Dua in the month of Sha'ban. And in relation to some of them, they said it's the first week of Sha'ban, Al-Athar. It's not a hadith, Athar we call it. And other narrations, but the first Sunday of Sha'ban. And other narrations, they say it's in the middle of Sha'ban. So we have to mention all. Right? All right. Something else also about Sha'ban, which is very important for us. Very, very important. And it's beloved to our hearts, and we have to pay attention to it. Month of Sha'ban, the ulama, they used to call it the month of salawat upon Rasulullah. Why? Because they said the verse, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا اللَّهُمَّ صَلِّ وَسَلِّمْ وَبَارِكْ عَلَيْهِ وَعَلَى آلِهِ. They said this verse was revealed in the month of Sha'ban. Very important for us because this is something which is we love. Salawat upon Rasulullah. A deed which for sure going to be accepted. If you want to perform a deed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept for sure from you, recite salawat upon Rasulullah. Allah will accept. Even riyad, we are teaching about this. Even show off, Allah will accept. And you're sitting somewhere and doing nothing. A man came to you, he straight away took your tasbih from your pocket, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad, Allahumma salli. Just to show him, why he said Allah, mashallah, this person. Your intention is not that, right? Show off, like, riyah. But al ulama said, even if it's show off, that deed will be accepted. Why? Inna Allaha wa malaikatahu. There is nur here. Allah. وملائكته يصلون على النبي. طيب. There is no. يا الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه. Now, يا believer, recite salawat. So that you will be rewarded. If that salawat came out from our mouth with a not good intention, not sincere intention, that means darkness. Correct?
Yeah.
But it's going to join what? The nur of إن الله وملائكته. So that darkness will disappear. Will be only nur of inna allaha wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Therefore, your salawat upon Rasulullah for sure will be accepted. So the month of salawat. That's why you see al ulama in the month of Sha'ban, they will recite lots of salawat. Are we going to do that, inshallah? Yeah, hopefully, inshallah. Make use of it. Make use of it. So don't lose this opportunity. Use it, but don't lose it. Right? And in the month of Sha'ban, Also, they said, Subhanallah, the Zamzam, the Bear Zamzam, the well of Zamzam, there is a narration that the water will be increased. Not only in Zamzam, everywhere. The water, remember those days in Iraq when we are small, those people who they want to water their garden, there is a shed, and you cannot water your Bangalore as you like. There is a date for you and a time for you. Every week, your time from, for example, 3 to 6. Because the river is not small and not enough, because there are many, otherwise it would be a problem. So, but in the Nisfu Sha'ban, especially, and you know, those people, what they will do, open for all, anytime. Because the water will be increased, subhanAllah, the level. Ajeeb, this is something which is, So Allahu A'lam, this is all something which is, the month of in the month of Sha'ban. طيب, one more thing about Sha'ban. In Shama'il Muhammadiyah by Sayyidina Imam al-Tirmidhi, this is a book of the humble lifestyle, a humble and simple lifestyle of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He's talk about his ibadah, his tahajjud, his salat, his dress. So in a door of fasting of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, narration. عن سيدنا أم سلمة رضي الله عنها أم سلمة سيد قالت ما رأيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يصوم شهرين متتابعين إلا شعبان ورمضان سيدنا أم سلمة said I have not seen رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم fast 2 months consecutively I mean always oftenly except شعبان and رمضان Ramadan, we know, it's fard. But Sunnah, Siyam Sunnah or something, here we have not seen him completely fast month other than, beside Ramadan, other than Sha'ban. So when Sayyidina Rasulullah fast the whole month, that must be special. In other narrations, عن عائشة رضي الله عنها. سيدنا عائشة also. He said, لم أرى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يصوم في شهر أكثر من صيامه في شعبان. كان يصوم شعبان إلا قليلا بل كان يصومه كله. Which means, عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها وأرضاها said, I did not see the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم fast during a month more than his fasting during the month of شعبان. She had not seen him fasting other than, you know, month like Sha'ban. He would fast during Sha'ban and have a little, he just little few days he won't fast. He would, in fact, she said, he would fast in the, all of it, all of the month. Al-ulama said, why she said, not all, because he had to keep a gap between Ramadan and Sha'ban. You cannot receive Ramadan with fasting. العلماء said unless is a عادة يعني for example you used to fast Monday Thursday let's say tomorrow Friday Ramadan first day of Ramadan and today call it Thursday you used to fast Thursday then fast it no issue as long as Siyam Sunnah and you used to do that is okay but however if someone wants to fast Ramadan, tomorrow is Ramadan, you say, some of, you know, announcement Ramadan here and there. There is a doubtful day sometimes. For the people, if you fast today to say, okay, tomorrow might be Ramadan in Singapore, but in other countries maybe earlier. So I fast today and tomorrow. So I mean, no, that cannot be. This is wrong. You will fast in your place where they announce Ramadan, start with them and end with them. Is it clear? All right? No need to, in advance, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said من صام اليوم الذي يشك فيه الناس فقد عصى أبا القاسم. The one who fasts the day which people doubt, have doubt of it, he have gone against سيدنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. عصى. معصية. May Allah protect us. So here, these two hadith narrated about the month of Sha'ban. And there are other things happening in fact in the month of Sha'ban. If you go to the Islamic history, of course, Sayyid Muhammad also, there is a book, Tariq al-Hawadith al-Hawadith al-Nabawiyya, where he mentioned about certain incidents happened during in the life of Islam during different months like Shaaban, so Ramadan all. Ramadan, there are many things happen in Ramadan as well. So among that, he mentioned about in Shaaban about certain things also happen in the month of Shaaban. So now let us, inshallah, cover the topic of Shaaban, it's Nisfu Shaaban. Because that is what everyone, all of us, we go to masjid, we find the people in masjid, Nisfu Shaaban, performing ibadah, sitting together, reading Quran, Yasin. So, التابعين, the followers of Sahaba. Especially التابعين, those the followers of Sahaba, أهل الشام, Syria. The التابعين, who live in Sham, the very famous ulama, the followers of Sahaba, رضي الله عنها, they used to say that to spend the night in masajid during Nisf Sha'ban is something good, encouraged to do. But we cannot say sunnah or wajib, no. And we have to understand this, it's encouraged. But if you not do it, there is no punish, but you will lose the reward. In general, it's good to be at the masjid all the time. And no one can say, don't go to masjid and sit with people and recite Quran. Today in our Majlis Mawlid at Masjid Abdul Razzaq, we mentioned about the hadith of the barakah of Majalis Dhikrullah. Al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in riwayat Musnad Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, that Sayyidina Salman al-Farisi, radiallahu anhu wa arwah, said that once we were sitting at the masjid, group of us, Sahaba, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came all the way, and he said salam to them, and he seated in the middle of them. So they were surprised, something unusual. Come, you know, and sit in the middle of them. So they were looking to him. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I have seen the rahmah, mercy of Allah descending upon you, so I came to share it with you. Allah. Can you imagine? This just in masjid, normal gathering. How about in a specific and special month? It must be great. Al-Imam Abdullah Al-Ghimari is muhaddith, great muhaddith, and he deal with al-hadith, the muhaddithin. From Morocco, and he's Maliki madhab. He didn't mention about the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ فِي أَيَّامِ دَهْرِكُمْ لَنَفَحَاتْ فَتَعَرَّبُوا لَهَا. Which means, in the days and nights of your year and your life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have assigned spiritual waves where you might get the khushur, tranquility. So therefore, try to face it, try to get it, don't lose it. So if there is khilaf, there is opinions about Nisfu Shaaban, because there might people discourage. You know, there are some of, you know, different thoughts. That's why I say Muhammad notion must be corrected. You know, people don't encourage people to go and to massage during Nisfu Shaaban, because they say al-hadith da'if. Here, if you talk about al-muhaddithin, they know what the meaning of hadith, like weak hadith. Weak hadith, if we have from many directions, come to us, but talking about the importance of Nisfu Shaaban, these hadith, when get together from different directions, will strengthen the evidence of barakah of Nisfu Shaaban. We are talking about Nisf Sha'ban, what? There are hadith, stronger hadith about Nisf Sha'ban. Talk about the Nisf Sha'ban itself. I'm talking about the gathering in the month in the Nisf Sha'ban. The Nisf Sha'ban, no one can say there is nothing. No one can say there is nothing. Because in the narration, for example, Imam al-Ahmad bin Tirmidhi wa bin Majah, Sayyidina Aisha radiallahu anha wa arbaha, she said, I missed Sayyid Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that night. And she woke up and she saw that he is not there in his bed. So I went searching of him. And she went searching of him. Then I saw him at البقيع جنة البقيع رافع رأسه إلى السماء. He was raising his hand and praying to Allah. So when I came and he noticed that and then she said, you're a bit worried about me. She said, yes, Ya Rasulullah. I thought you went to someone, other wife's house. تيت بعض نسائك يعني. She said to her, صلى الله عليه وسلم, there is a special rahmah descend from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at Nisif Sha'ban, in the night of Nisif Sha'ban, to heaven, to dunya. And Allah forgive people, offer forgiveness to people more than the sheep of the tribe of Kalb. What that mean? He give a logic, give something, an example. In Arab history, there are two tribes used to fight each other. They are cousins. So, at the end of the story, anyway, for years they kill each other, killing blood between them. But they made a peace agreement that the loser, Bani Kalb, Kalb, he's a king, his name Kalb. His tribe, they want to make sure that they won't fight anymore. They took all their horses and camels and replace it with sheep. For each one horse, they give 10 sheep. So that in the future they won't fight. They won't use it to fight and they can. Because of that, they have lots of sheep. And you know, the sheep always, you know, increase. That's why they said, when you see the sheep, there is a beginning to them, but there is no end. That tribe, lots of sheep. So when anyone mentions about something, you say, he has money like Kalb tribe, Allah Akbar, you say. Sometimes you see this person has something like sea to exaggerate, you know? So Sayyidina Rasulullah is exaggeration about the barakah of his tribe. You say, Allah forgive more than the people of Bani Kalb. I mean, the sheep of the people, he will offer his forgiveness. So it's barakah in Allah. Why he go to Ahlul Baqiyah? Because they are beloved to him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when I think first thing he will do, he will share even the dua with them. And in the hadith, Ibn Majah, he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will see all his people, offer special forgiveness in the night of Nisfu Sha'ban. And he will forgive all, except two. Two, they are not including the forgiveness. Who are they? Mushrik. Amma is not mushrik, not an unbeliever. And Mushahin. Mushahin, troublemakers. Troublemakers. Create fitna between here and there. Make trouble. His one also not included. You say, how bad is this person? May Allah protect us. This person needs special night. Leave the little qadr only. Because he needs for Allah to forgive him special forgiveness and to change his life, you know. But this one is for those who they want reward. Sha'ban is reward. And he forgive Allah offer his reward and forgive the people. But Laylatul Qadr, he need, I think, the Mushahid, because he created lots of fitna in his life, breaking families. Therefore, he need Laylatul Qadr night. Allah to forgive him. But if he asks Allah forgiveness, Allah Ghafoor Rahim. Now, there is a narration also by Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim, in Sahih al-Bukhari Muslim, where the hadith of Imran bin Husayn radiallahu anhu, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ask him, Ya Fulan, Ama hamamta min sira lihad al-shahr? See, have you not got any barakah of this month? You're talking about Sha'ban with Imran's name. He said, no, Ya Rasulullah. Have you not got any barakah from this month? No. Said, no, Ya Rasulullah. He said, if you able, إِذَا أَفْتَرْتَ فَصُمْ يَوْمَيْنْ مِنْ سَرْهَذَا. He said, at least to fast 2 days of this month. Don't lose. يعني, encourage him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to fast in the month of Sha'ban. So there is barakah. When Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam direct him, that means there is a barakah for us, all of us, inshallah. So there are barakat. There are barakat in this month. And we therefore we have to use it. And then Al-Imam Al-Karmani, Al-Ulama, and he was mentioning about Khalid bin Mi'dad and Uthman bin Amr, the tabi'een. He said, those are tabi'een, the followers of Sahaba, what they used to do, يَكَانُوا يَلْبَسُونَ فِيهَا أَحْسَنَ ثِيَابِهِمْ. They will wear the best of dresses. تَلْبَاجُوا يَعْنِيهَا. وَيَتَبَخَّرُونَ غَهَرُوا. وَيَبْتَحِذُونَ. They put surma, kuhul. وَيَقُومُونَ فِي الْمَسْجِدِ لَيْلَةٌ تِلْكَ. And they will spend the whole night qiyam al-layl that night. And he said, Al-Imam, and they said, that's how we used to do together. Maybe someone will say, okay, it's not used to be Rasulullah's as jama'ah. Why not individual? Well, if you want to do it individually, example, you think you will able to do that? Huh? The first thing you open the Quran, say, I will read Yasin. Next year, inshallah. You lose a barakah. Sayyidina Rasulullah, at least two days, if you find. But where is Jama'ah? Sayyidina Rasulullah said, I saw that this year, that's masjid, Baytullah. Baytullah is used what? Allah's houses. Houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To get what? The barakah. Majlis zikr itself is great, no matter where. Majlis zikr in Allah's house, that even greater. Majlis zikr, Allah's house, good gathering. In the majlis for Sha'bah, wallahi, that's a barakah. Huh? And all of us need, Sayyidina Rasulullah said, a special web. Nafahat, don't lose it. Try to catch it. We question always. We not question. Why? Because we are lazy. We just want to find a way to say that it's not so that I say, Allah, Allah, so. Then go home to do what? Give with the wife and the children with the one. Nothing. But spend it with the masjid. Ya akhi, ask her, one sujood. That sujood will witness for you. The sujood, what? Salah, jama'ah, read Yasin. Yasin is a special blessing in Surah Yasin. And there's a special dua if you recite together. Ya akhi, somebody say, who say Yasin? I say, read the Quran. Read the Quran. Anyone can say anything? No problem. Say that too long. Okay, then Yasin, ya akhi. So, Imam Shafi'i also, example, regarding this, said, Imam Shafi'i in his book Al-Umm, the book of fiqh of Madhab Shafi'i, they call Al-Umm, the mother. Imam Shafi'i, Imam Shafi'i, radiallahu anhu, said, وَبَلَغَنَا أَنَّهُ كَانَ يُقَالُ إِنَّ الدُّعَاءَ يُسْتَجَابُ فِي خَمْسِ لَيَالٍ. Imam Shafi'i said, we have reached to us, we have got narration that the dua will be accepted in 5 nights. Dua will be accepted in what? Lima malam, you know? Lima malam, 5 nights. Lima malam. Lima malam. Huh? Okay, what is that? Laylatil Jum'ah. Malam Jum'ah. Thursday, tomorrow Jum'ah. Dua will be accepted. Laylatul Adha, night of Eid al-Adha. Like Muzdalifa, tomorrow is Eid. Right, Arafa, tomorrow's Eid, dua will be accepted. Laylatul Fitr, Ariraya Eid al-Fitri, that night. But of course, you know, this sunnah of Laylatul Fitr, still a lot to go. But most of the people, at the end of last day of Ramadan, tomorrow's Eid, no one will see him doing any ibadah. This is one of the sunnah which been forgotten. Spend the whole night until 27, Ramadan, finish, Allah said, Masajid will be empty, ajeeb. Well, don't count the numbers of days. Count Allah's rahmah first. Try to get a closeness to Allah. Yeah? There is nearness to Allah and there is closeness to Allah. Correct? What's the difference between nearness and closeness? The king or the prime minister or VVIP next your house, your neighbor with him. Someone will say, you know him? I have something, I have hajat. Can you ask him? Say, look, he is my neighbor, but I'm not close to him. Correct? I'm not close. Nearby, not that being close. This is a month when we try to be close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? This is a month because Allah offered that. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. This is between verses of fasting. I said, I'm near. So don't, if you have any haja to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, don't lose the opportunity of acceptance of dua, inshaAllah. in the month of Ramadan and at the end of Ramadan, Laylatul Fitr. The Imam Shafi'i, he said that dua makbul in Laylatul Jum'ah, Laylatul Hari Raya Hajji, Hari Raya Eidul Fitri, and the first night of Rajab, right? And Laylatul Nisf min Sha'ban. And the dua in Malam Nisfu, Sha'ban. That's what Sayyidina al-Imam al-Shafi'i radiallahu anhu wa arzah said about it. So we have to make use of these blessings in the month of Sha'ban to receive Ramadan ready. So don't let people say, I will eat more now in the Sha'ban because Ramadan coming, so I cannot eat like before. This is Ramadan, change habits, and change habits start from now. Now. Count. Counting. Now is how many days until Ramadan? Today is what? Sha'ban. Today is 8th of Sha'ban. Tomorrow, 9th. Malam, 9 of Sha'ban. Tomorrow, 9th. Yani, later on, you will find yourself. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfirullah, nas'aluka al-jannata wa na'udhu bika min an-nar. Allahumma innaka afuwwun fa'fu 'anna ya kareem. Ramadan. Now we have to do that. Now you have to stand by for Ramadan. As-Sahaba radiallahu anhum wa arzahum, they know not the month of Ramadan, they know the blessing of Ramadan. Where Allah offers. So they stand by for the month of Ramadan 6 months before Ramadan. 6 months getting, they know Allah for this Ramadan, how great month. One night of ibadah in Laylatul Qadr equal to 1,000 months of ibadah. Payment in one night equal to 1,000 months of payments. So who can offer that only Allah? And what payment is this? He will give you the best fi rabbana atina fi dunya hasana wa fi al-akhirati hasana wa qina adhaban. We have to make use of this barakah. Don't lose it. Today is what? Tomorrow, Monday, sahih? Fasting good in Monday or not? Yes. Sunnah or not? Yes. In the month of Sha'ban? Yes. Can you fast tomorrow? Yes. Don't you know, inshallah, ya Allah, bi'idhni Allah, I will fast tomorrow. Easy, akhi, here, wallahi, easy. The time is flies. But when tomorrow you decide to fast, you say, next Monday, because you know, just before. And at last you find yourself, first night of Ramadan, khalas, you lost the nafahat, it's gone. So inshallah we try our best bi'idhnillah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enter Ramadan ready, spiritually ready, our heart, our everything ready to do more worship. Most of the special dua we have to ask Allah in the month of Sha'ban. Ya Allah, change our habits in the month of Ramadan. No, we don't want fast to breakfast, fast to worship. Huh? We have to do that inshallah. He will help. All of us are hajjah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will make it easy. If Allah accept dua, but he offer a special offer for us to get the barakah of acceptance of dua, which is in the month of Ramadan, the month of Sha'ban, and inshallah we'll make use of it. Try to attend the barakah of the blessings of this Sha'ban, where we recite the Yasin together, ask Allah barakah, be in a masjid, bring your children, let them enjoy also, let them study, let them get the blessing of nafahat. Allah offer that night special forgiveness, special barakah from Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. If they got these waves, halas, it will be ease for you. No need for you to be tired. Because Allah pleased with them, and He will make it ease for all of you, inshallah. And they will get what they want. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-barakah fi al-dunya wal-akhirah. Lastly, al-imam, Sayyidina al-imam Jalal al-Din al-Suyuti. Jalal al-Din al-Suyuti, of course, you know, al-imam al-Suyuti, يعني توقف علماء. All the Muslim ummah depend on his books. Al-imam Jalal al-Suyuti here talk about his experience. What he said? He said, قَالَ فِي جَمْعِ الْجَوَامِعِ Sayyidina al-imam Jalal al-Suyuti, من أحيا ليلتي العيدين وليلة النصف من شعبان لم يمت قلبه يوم تموت القلوب. The one who met ركعات التهجد in two nights of الفطر عيد الفطر العيد الأضحى and نصف شعبان the result of it if he managed to do إحياء يعني قيام الليل his heart won't die when the heart's going to die then your heart will be alive we need this صحيح why because there's special shower in these three nights we have to make use of you know make use of them is Allah's barakah losing this opportunity losing sea of blessings we don't want to use that if we have seas of blessings already then don't in fact don't have even a glass yeah. so inshallah Allah will make us among الصائمين المنيبين الخاشعين الخاضعين المتقين in the month of شعبان and in the month of Ramadan and after Ramadan, before Ramadan, during Ramadan, after Ramadan, all the way because we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Rabbu Ramadan, the Lord of Ramadan. We are not worshiping Ramadan. And we won't worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the month of Ramadan only. But inshallah we stand by for the special ibadah in the month of Ramadan. And remember, the best Ramadan became blessed because of what? Al-Quran. شهر رمضان What is Ramadan? الَّذِي أُنزِلَ فِيهِ الْقُرْآنِ This is a month of Quran. Try to do more. Recite more. تدرس, تلقي, تدبر. Don't lose this opportunity. Make more dua, more sujood, more qiyam, more tahajjud. We are in need for these blessings. The time is running and we don't know when is the end. May Allah protect us from سوء الخاتمة and bless us with حسن الخاتمة. So inshallah Allah grant you all baraka fi dunya wal akhirah. Allahumma aslih halana wa hal al muslimin min hal ila ahsan hal. Allahumma barik fi ahwalina wa aqwalina wa af'alina wa azwajina wa dhurriyyatina. Allahumma tub alayna tawbatan nasuha. Allahumma ighfir lana, Allahumma barik lana, barik fi umurina ad-diniyya wa ad-dunyawiyya wa al-akhrawiyya. اللهم نسألك أن تغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من رحمتك إنك أنت الوهاب وهب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين للمتقين إماما ربنا اغفر لنا وآبائنا وأزواجنا وأمهاتنا والمسلمين والمسلمات المؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم الأموات اللهم خص بالخاصة وخصوصا الجماعة الحاضرين والحاضرات والدينا والديهم أزواجنا وأزواجهم ذرياتنا وذرياتهم ارضى عنا يا الله بما رضيت بها عبادك الصالحين واجعلنا من عبادك الصالحين هداة المهتدين لا ضالين لا ضالين ولا مضلين وافتح علينا فتوح العارفين برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين ربنا اتنا في الدنيا حسنه وفي الاخره حسنه وقنا عذاب النار وعلى هذه النية وعلى الدنيا صالحا لله سبحانه وتعالى والى حضرة النبي سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم الفاتحه